Now we're going to use the graph given here to estimate derivatives, slopes of tangent lines from the graph. So it says use the given graph to estimate the value of each derivative. Hint, think the slope of the tangent line. It may help to draw in the tangent lines. So the first derivative it asks us to find, the first slope, is the slope of the tangent line at negative 3. So here's negative 3. I draw in a tangent line here. And if I draw it well, it looks like it should be nice and flat. It's the top of the hill there. So anytime you have the top of a hill or the bottom of a hill, like over here at 4, you're going to have a slope of 0. Right, next, it asks us to find the slope at negative 1. So at negative 1, right here, if we draw on a tangent line, here it's harder to be sure, but it looks like the tangent line looks something like this. And if I pick some points on this line to look at, here is negative 1, 1, and then here's negative 2, 3, and negative 3, 5. It looks like the change in y is about 2, and the change in x is about 1, so this should be 2 over 1, which is 2. If we look at f prime at 0, here is a very interesting thing. Because if I put a point here where x is 0, and I pick any point over here on the right side to estimate the tangent line, it would look like this. But if I pick any point over here on the left side to estimate the tangent line, it's going to look something like this. And as you can see, those slopes are going to disagree. So the limit as h goes to 0 from the left side is going to not equal the limit as h goes to 0 from the right side. Or we could write this in derivative notation saying that f prime from the left side at 0 does not equal f prime from the right side at 0. And just like with our regular limits, this is a limit. So if you get two different answers from the two different sides, then the limit does not exist. Now let's look at f prime of 1. At 1, our function is actually a straight line, and that means that its tangent line is itself. So if we just pick any two points on this line, at 1, it looks like we're at the point 1, 1 half, and at 2, it looks like we're at the point 2, 2 and a half. That would make our change in y 2 and our change in x 1. So we get 2 over 1, which is 2. Ooh, and look, I've realized that we did something wrong back there in f prime of negative 1 because we shouldn't have got the same answer at 1 and at negative 1, should we? So we have to be careful here. At negative 1, we should have had a point of negative 2, 3, and a point of negative 1, 1. The change in y here is going 1 minus 3 is a negative 2, and negative 1 minus 2 is a positive 1. So we should have had negative 2 over 1, so negative 2 actually at negative 1. And that makes sense because, as you can see here, this tangent line is going downhill and should have a negative slope. All right, we've got one more tangent line to do, and that is f prime of 2. But f prime of 2 is going to have the exact same problem that we had at 0. It's got this sharp corner here, and this sharp corner is going to tell us that if I take the tangent line, if I look at the tangent line on the left side and the tangent line on the right side, their slopes are not going to agree. So again, we're going to get dNe. So what we've learned here is a sharp corner called in math a cusp means that the derivative there does not exist.